start by saying this is definitely a day that gives reason and cause for us to celebrate. I want to start with a special message for the homeowners who are in this area, along with the business owners, and I want to just tell you about what this kickoff symbolizes. Almost a quarter of a million dollar investment, 14 parcels, 12 small businesses, one new business coming, over an 85% commitment from current business owners to participate, sandwiched by two neighborhood commercial corridors, Wadsworth Avenue and Stenton Avenue, well, three, and Ogontz Avenue, which boast an 85% occupancy rate. And I'm not sure how many of you saw that we made the New York Times last week. And one of the things they talked about in this community was the overwhelmingly high rate of home ownership that we have, which is a 71% home ownership rate. So today is definitely a reason to celebrate. This is the model for a public-private partnership between private industry along with government. The investment in our neighborhood business corridor, along with the businesses that have stayed here for so long. And I need to say to the residents and to the business owners, you know that we didn't just start yesterday on this. There was no crisis mode or action that moved this. This planning started 15 to 20 years ago when Mayor Kenney was a member of council. And Mayor Kenney, the issue we were working on was called the Neighborhood Transformation Initiative. And Pastor Waller, you'll remember the recommendations from the architects and engineers were that this whole strip just be demolished and we start from scratch. Our challenge was we couldn't get the money for acquisition. And after communicating with the business owners and the residents, we had several meetings down the street at E9 Tabernacle Baptist Church about what the community wanted this to look like so that the design would be driven from the ground up and not elected officials or anyone who lived outside of this neighborhood coming in to tell the people what was best for them. This historic revitalization project will include storefront facade improvements, increase in lighting and pedestrian scale lighting, restoring the recessed lighting implanted along the businesses, streetscape enhancements that will include my favorite things, trees and lights on trees, new signage and banners, branding this community as what it was when you first purchased your house here. It wasn't called Cedarbrook, Jerry Sizemore. It was called Mount Airy. Adding trash receptacles to encourage cleanliness, beautifying the island that is right down the street at Missioner and Vernon Road, at the Missioner and Vernon Road intersection that mirrors what you see when you cross Cheltenham Avenue coming from Montgomery County at Cheltenham and Wadsworth Avenue. And probably most important for us from a public safety perspective, it is upgrading and adding security cameras to this corridor. And we want to promote Vernon Road as one of the safest neighborhood commercial corridors in our city. With this in mind, I want to thank you, Mayor Kenney, and Commerce Director Harold Epps. And I have to say this for the record. You heard me mention that this was 15 to 20 years in the making, and you've only been elected since January, Mayor Kenney. And Epps, I don't think you've got here until February. And we are here to kick off almost a quarter of a million dollars investment in this region. State Senator Art Hayward and State Representative Tanyelle Cook Artis, when we received the good news from the Commerce Department and the Mayor's Office, we knew that we needed to leverage the private investment. We called you, Senator, we called you, Representative Cook Artis, the way we've always done to get anything accomplished in our neighborhood. City investment, private investment, but we needed something from the state. And both of you responded in the affirmative, and I want to say thank you. I want to say to Brad Copeland and the Mount Airy USA team, and Harold Treatman, where are you? I really do, Harold, mean to put you on the spot. Vernon Road, Ogontz Avenue, Wadsworth Avenue, and Stenton is not considered to be a traditional part of what was Mount Airy USA's targeted area to work in. But they have partnered with some new partners that we have in the area, and we're relying on them for a lot, and that is Michael Rashid, Mikhail Shabazz, Azor Robinson, and fellow board members at Medina CDC, born out of Mass Jujula, and that investment that was made at Washington Lane and Upsell. I am very Washington Lane and Limekiln Pike. I am very, very grateful for that. To Reverend Waller, we can't say thank you enough to you for your leadership. You did not lose patience with us. You allow E9 to be open so that when we needed to have meetings, when we needed your leadership and your guidance, you have always been there, and you have not sort of just been worried about development on the land that E9 owns. The advancement and investment in this community has mattered to you. You made it a priority, and we want to say thank you. Let me say to Wells Fargo, you and your Neighborhood LIFT program, when Mayor Kenney and the Commerce Department called us to tell us about your investment, and I know you're going to specifically, Greg, talk about that, we were excited because you heard me mention that there's a 71% home ownership rate in this city, in this neighborhood, but not everyone in this neighborhood feels as if they're often eligible for many of the programs that are offered to stabilize the aging infrastructure. So when you said that you were going to invest and they knew that their tax dollars would be at work, this was a perfect marriage. And so, you know, I wouldn't be Cherelle Parker if I didn't say thank you and make an ask. We're happy to announce the kickoff today, and this is the first phase, but we've partnered Wells Fargo, and we don't want to let you go, and we're hoping that you will stay with us in the future. With that being said, Shirley Armstead of Armstead Real Estate, and to all of the business owners, you never left us. You stayed. And we don't want any of you to think that we take it lightly. Thank you so very much. The staff, Karen Fegley, Yvonne Boy, Nazara, Jahai Lee, Gianna, Salim, Brad and Aaron, Dana, Kurt, Darren, who are with CICADA Architects. When you look at the renderings, you can tell it wasn't just thrown together, Gary Shepherd. They took some time and energy to make sure that the quality you would see in other neighborhoods would be the quality that we had here. So thank you all so very much, and we will now hear from Mayor Kenney.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Very early in the administration, Harold Epps and I concluded that if we told Cherelle no, she would hunt us down. So. We love you, but fear meets speed, trust me. She does a wonderful job here. You can't find a better district council person in the country, let alone in the city. Philadelphia's success is dependent upon the success of businesses of all sizes in all neighborhoods. Our administration is especially committed to ensuring that our neighborhood businesses get to be a part of the commercial renaissance happening in Philadelphia. We have seen great growth in Center City and the surrounding areas, and we want all of our neighborhoods to experience that opportunity. The Planning Commission estimates that there are about 265 commercial corridors throughout our city, and it is obvious that these corridors are an essential part of the fabric of Philadelphia's neighborhoods. The business owners who operate along our commercial corridors, including those here in Mount Airy, reflect the commitment of local entrepreneurs to our city. They reflect the diversity of Philadelphia, and we must take the necessary steps to invest in them. When we talk about investments, they can be as simple as connecting projects across multiple departments or increasing funding for the Department of Commerce's development initiatives like the Storefront Improvement Program, which funds nearly 100 projects per year. We are also looking at innovative ways to repurpose vacant lots and adding new streetscape features to breathe life into the commercial corridors that we love and support. It's amazing what a fresh coat of paint, new signage, and other renovations can do to give businesses staying power and instill a sense of pride and hope among residents. At the end of the day, stronger businesses mean more jobs and better neighborhoods for all Philadelphia, and I think we can all get behind that. So let me tell you, as an individual who has grown up, was born, raised, and grow up and will die in this city, hopefully not anytime soon, there's always been a business trip in my life. In South Philadelphia, growing up in around 2nd Street, South 7th Street was a strong commercial corridor where my mother bought everything that on every part of put it on clothing on every part of our body and food and did her banking there. And as I moved into another part of South Philadelphia, East Passyunk Avenue was clearly an anchor in the neighborhood and needed to be propped up at a certain period of time, and now that's taken off. I wanted to say to the business owners here, we know how hard it is to stay in business. I mean, economies go up and down, but you still got to make your payroll. You still got to collect your receivables. You still got to make your investments. You still have to keep up your properties. You still have to take life seriously every single day in order to be successful. And the longer you stay in business, that means the commitment that you made to not only this particular neighborhood business trip, but to our city and to the people who live in our city. So thank you to the business people here. I think you really... You deserve this treatment. You deserve this renovation. So thank you all for being here today. All the clergy folks that are here, it's just nice to see that our Muslim friends and our Baptist friends are working together for the betterment of our city. You know, as I said, 30% of our city practice the Islamic faith. And we have always endeavored to stand up against injustice towards people because of their religion. You know, I'm a Irish Catholic, and there was a time in our country's history and our city's history where they were trying to keep us from coming in and sending us back where we came from. So as long as we all stick together as religious people, as government people, as neighborhood people, as business people, our city's going to take off and continue to take off. So I'm honored to be your mayor at this moment. Thank you.
So good afternoon. I am Harold Epps, the Director of Commerce for the city, and I'm going to be very, very brief. But I want to tell you about your councilwoman, Cherelle Parker. Now, there are 7 days out of the week, and we don't mind when we are called upon, but Cherelle picks February 27th, which happened to be a Saturday. I went back and checked, and says, we're going to do a neighborhood tour. Now, it doesn't get that cold in Philadelphia, but it was a little chilly that day. And we go to Wadsworth and we go to some other places, but she says, you gotta go see Vernon Road. And we come to Vernon Road and she tells us her vision. And she says, and we are gonna make this happen and we're gonna make it happen now. I go back and tell the mayor and he says, well, Cherelle says it, we gotta make it happen. So she has been adamant about that. And what I want to say, and I will then pass the baton, is this is your neighborhood and these stores have been here, and I, as Director of Commerce, would only encourage you to pass the word on. As we invest in them, we need you to continue to invest in your community by spending your money with these store owners. So please do that, and we will continue to be your partner, and congratulations for this first step. We'll be back to help you with additional steps. Thank you. Congratulations.
Well, good afternoon. I'm Greg Redden, the region president for Wells Fargo, and this is an amazing day here in Mount Airy. At Wells Fargo, we are focused on helping our customers and our communities thrive and succeed financially. And that includes providing assistance to help qualified prospective home buyers achieve sustainable home ownership and help stabilize and revitalize neighborhoods here in Philadelphia. And one of the ways we're supporting that effort is through our Neighborhood LIFT program. In March, we partnered with the city to announce an innovative effort to help boost home ownership and improve neighborhoods across the city of Philadelphia. This effort, called Neighborhood LIFT, was held at Center City Sheraton in April, and this included a $5 million investment from Wells Fargo to the city. $4 million of that investment was used for down payment assistance grants for qualified homeowners. The investment was also used to support programs to help prospective home buyers achieve successful, sustainable home ownership. And then finally, this investment includes local initiative grant funds, one of which we're presenting here today. All told, these investments will accelerate neighborhood recovery and help revitalize and strengthen neighborhoods across the city. The Wells Fargo Neighborhood LIFT program is making a difference by helping qualified individuals in our communities become first-time home buyers or re-enter the housing market to be able to own a home again. In Philadelphia, we were able to provide down payment assistance grants to literally hundreds of folks to get them into new homes. And we're proud of the tremendous partnership that's been forged between Wells Fargo and the City of Philadelphia to support homeowners and future home buyers and help create sustainable neighborhood work like you're seeing here today. So as part of the investment in this great city, today Wells Fargo will be presenting $100,000 in grant funds to the Mount Airy USA. And Mount Airy is one of five local nonprofit organizations that's going to be receiving funds such as this. The organizations that we selected have key focus areas, and that's around financial education and youth programs, housing and support for our small businesses that you heard Mayor Kenney speak of. So on behalf of Wells Fargo, I'd like to thank everyone here today for your support and advocacy for the Wells Fargo LIFT program and for the city. And I'd also like to acknowledge and thank Jim Kenney, the mayor. Of course, we've heard from Harold Epps, our city commerce director. You're going to be hearing from Art Haywood, state senator, here shortly. Tanyelle, thank you so much for having us here today. Brad Copeland, who you'll hear from, I believe, Michael Rashad, and Reverend Alan Walker, and then, of course, Stephen Briggs from Wells Fargo. So together, we're all going to make a difference of so many Philadelphians today. By supporting Mount Airy USA and other outstanding nonprofit organizations, Wells Fargo has the opportunity to support revitalization here in Philadelphia. So congratulations, and I'd like to present a check to you today.
Thank you to Councilwoman Parker and the mayor, Harold Epps, all that are gathered here, particularly the neighbors and the business owners. This is a great moment. I got to tell you, I've been involved in neighborhood revitalization for about 25 years, including Progress Plaza, as a lawyer for Ogden's Avenue Revitalization and North Fifth Street. And seeing investment come into a neighborhood is really the core for what has been called uplift. And the neighbors are the shoppers, the ones to support it. The business owner, I can only commend you all for hanging in, and for those who are coming in, this is a great community. I just want to share that obviously I'm glad that with Rep. Tanelle Artis, we were able to bring some state resources in. And the state resources are important along with the city, along with the private foundations. But the investment that generates the state, the local, the foundation, that investment is you all. You all have already invested in the houses. You all have already invested in the stores. We as a community have made the investment. And so what we are doing is nothing but demonstrating we're demonstrating what we owe to each other, what we owe to you all, to the neighbors, what we owe to each other. And in that regard, I just wanted to add one other thing before I talk more about money. In order for our communities to remain strong, we have to participate in those communities. And I've got, and you may know, I'm promoting three ways that we can participate in stronger communities. One of them is shopping local. We spend our money here, the jobs will be here, the businesses will be here, and this will not be an area that was once in trouble. It'll be a thriving area if we shop here, if we spend our money here. The second thing that I believe we need to do in terms of participate is if you see something, say something. If you see something suspicious, report it. That's how we build community. See something, say something. And the last thing I've been really encouraging is that we focus on reading. Now, I know there's a child care center. Those kids might be a little bit young to start reading. They're not. That's right. And it's particularly with the young people, if we can encourage and have them opportunities where we read aloud to them, those are solutions for our neighborhoods. But there's another solution that I'm glad to announce. The governor has a pot of money called RACP. It's got a few million dollars in it. And we were able to get $1 million for the revitalization of Northwest. $1 million. Obviously, I'm glad that in the short time I've been in the legislature, we've been able to bring $1 million to this neighborhood. And as I've pledged to Cherelle Parker, I believe that our team can be as great as any other team in bringing money and resources to this community and coming up with solutions, the solutions that we all need, the solutions that we all need to participate in. So thank you again, particularly thank you to all who have already invested as we follow what you have started. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I am State Representative Tanya Cook Artis, and I am truly excited to be here on today. I'm excited to be standing here today with Councilwoman Cherelle Parker, Reverend Waller, State Senator Hayward, and the other agencies represented behind me. As a child, I remember walking from St. Raymond's, visiting the corner store, getting candy that I know I didn't have no business having. But I also witnessed the challenges that this commercial corridor experienced. And it just didn't happen this past election. It's always been here. For the past 10 years, Councilman Parker, then State Representative, and Reverend Waller took on the task to address the challenges that were facing this area from the community meetings and the stakeholders planning meetings. It was determined by all that a change had to come. As the words of Sam Cooke and putting a little twist to it, a change is going to come to Vernon Road.
Yeah, yeah.
In order for the change to come for this area, funding had to be secured from the various governmental and financial agencies, as well as the buy-in from the residents in this area and the business owners for the facade improvements, the greenery, and the increased lighting. These improvements are just a beginning of what the residents of this area need and deserve. We elected officials and stakeholders have heard your cry, and now it's time to put the plan in action. As we stand here today, I'm glad to be part of the Vernon Road Revitalization Project, and I'm looking forward not only as an elected official for this area, but as a resident to witness the improvements and the continued call to action to address the quality of life for the residents of Vernon Road. I would like to give a special thank you to Mayor Kenney, Commerce Department, Wells Fargo, Minor USA, Medea, for believing in the vision that has been placed before us and helping to make that come to pass. Now it's time to go to work.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Cherelle Parker. Where are you at?
Cherelle.
Thank you. We have been involved. I moved into the neighborhood about 19 years ago. And 19, 20 years ago. And of course, the neighborhood was really bad. We tried to work with, Cherelle Parker worked with me. And you got to excuse, I'm a little excited because I was only told an hour ago that I was gonna speak. So I didn't have time to get my notes together or anything like that, so I'll speak from my heart. But for 13 years, I have had my office here. And the neighborhood has constantly been going down and down and down. But finally, with Ms. Parker, meeting Councilwoman Cherelle Parker, knowing her for about 13 years, and some of the gentlemen that are around here that have store owners, we have finally getting this dream come true that we will have a safe neighborhood. I think I speak for Vernon Road, Temple Road, all around. They want this to be a safe area. They want when their children play or come here and go to the stores, they don't want any bullets or flying around. Now, I think I speak for that. I speak that when they are afraid, if they hear something, they want police protection, they want police riding up and down, and they want to be able to shop without being afraid of going into the stores. Now, I know this. I speak for everybody. And two, and another thing that they would want, if they see something, they should not be afraid to tell. They should not be afraid to say anything. If a new store moves in and they see drugs passing around, they should be able to say, hey, I'm calling the police. And I want something done. Yes, Vernon Road has gotten out of hand. But we want to bring Vernon Road back. We need to bring Vernon Road back again so that we can have stores open for all races and religions here, and you can feel very safe when you own a property that's around us, because we need you, and we need you to be happy with us on Vernon Road. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Brad Copeland, the executive director for Mount Airy USA, with a raspier voice than usual, so I apologize. But on behalf of Mount Airy USA, I just want to say how grateful we are to be working on such an impactful project. I mean, I think the reason we all get up in the morning and do the work that we do is so that we can be part of supporting neighbors and our neighborhoods with projects like this. These kind of projects don't come together unless there is a lot of teamwork that goes into it. And I think you can say and see honestly that you have a really great team supporting this neighborhood with a very tenacious captain. I think we've heard that many times already today. I am looking at you, Councilwoman Parker. Also, with the kind of transformation that's going to happen here, there are a lot of things to be thankful for. And being thankful, particularly to the folks that provide the funding that make this possible, is an important part of what we do. So thank you to Mr. Redden and Wells Fargo for their investment with the Neighborhood LIFT funds. And thank you to Director Epps and our fine and esteemed mayor for the commerce funds that are going to flow in and transform these storefronts. And thank you, Representative Cook Artis, and last but certainly not least, our very fine Senator Art Haywood, for the RACP funds and other DCED funds that will make this possible. Mount Airy USA is very proud to be part of this team. So thank you very much.
Thank you. My name is Mike Rashid, and I'm a member of the board of directors of the Medina Community Development Corporation. Medina CDC is a relatively new community development corporation, but we are by no means new to this area. I mean, we have been in this area for over 30 years at Masjid Allah on Ogons Avenue and now Masjid Allah on the corner of Washington Lane and Limekin Pike. I think our involvement in this development is symbolic of the mayor and Mr. Epps and with the Commerce Department and our councilwoman, the way they are approaching helping local businesses get developed. We've only been in business for a year now, but they had the confidence in us, and we're not new to this, but we're a new organization, but they had the confidence in us to support us, along with Mount Airy and many other people, Wells Fargo, to support us in being the project manager for this development. So for those of us who are in business, we have small businesses, we have new businesses, we know how important it is for people to say, well, I'm going to take a chance on you. I'm going to have faith in you. Because if no one ever has faith in you, then you'll never get anywhere. So we just want to thank our mayor and thank our senator and thank Mount Airy and Wells Fargo and everybody who has supported us and who has shown faith in us. And we guarantee you we're going to work our fingers to the bone and make sure this is a successful project. Thank you so much.
Let me say good afternoon. My name is Alan Waller. I'm the senior pastor of the Enon Tabernacle Baptist Church. If you want to change the nature of the corner, you've got to address and change the corner store. If you want to fix the neighborhood, you have to address the commercial corridors. So we're grateful today for the leadership of Cherelle Parker, all of our government officials, and we want to thank you because this is our community. I'm simply here because we believe it takes a whole village to raise a child. It takes a church to raise a village. And so we're committed to making sure that this comes to pass. But also, Cherelle Parker said something, and she was right. She said, this ought to be a model. And the reason that it ought to be a model is that whenever you talk about dilapidation or how a neighborhood is run down, you can't just talk about that without talking about the causative factors that led to it. And in a very real sense, we all know that the sacrificial lamb of the gentrification of North Philly is Northwest Philly. We all know that as a commitment to fixing up Center City, then there was a loss in the neighborhoods. But this is not the only neighborhood, but this could be a model for how not only this neighborhood, but other neighborhoods will be picked up, will be transformed. And so we want to thank Cherelle Parker for her leadership. Want to thank our mayor for stepping in and stepping up. Want to thank our community partners for looking past the barriers that could possibly keep us apart and recognizing that we live in a season when we have to get past what is different and come together on what is divine and what is our responsibility. So I'm grateful to be a part of this, and we're looking forward to celebrating the businesses, to celebrating the look. There are those of us who are out here on Friday nights just making sure that everything is safe along with the police. But what we believe, there's coming a day when we won't have to be out here, because out here will be just like we want it to be. Thank you so much.
Spot, but only because some neighbors have asked, can you quickly talk about what E9 invested in that stadium, just so that people get how this meshes with that, the stadium where we have our youth activities?
Yeah, we invested in the stadium. What we believe is that the Lord allowed us to move our church up here because we have a commitment to young people. We are unapologetically youth-oriented. This neighborhood, there was an organization called Ports. People organized to restore Temple Stadium. They were the watchdog organization to make sure that whoever got this land would do right by the community. One of the things that they made sure, they said, whoever gets this land cannot overdevelop it. And what we said to them is, we have no intention of changing the exact nature of that back half. We want it for the football field. We want it for the baseball diamond. And so after we purchased and built the building, we then invested another $3 million in making sure that our children had the finest facilities. Our children don't need to go out into the county the first time they see a well-groomed football field.
That's right.
In fact, this is a gateway into Philadelphia. The county kids need to see that we have what they have. And so we invested in it so that our children would play on that which is perfect, that which is good. And then we're concerned about this corridor, because it means nothing to have a clean, wonderful football field within a bullet's distance.
Wow. Wow. Wow.
It means nothing to have all of that and even gated in if something can happen over here that can alter a life just around the corner. So we recognize that we're not only committed to the 34 acres that we have there, but we must needs be, that's church talk, we must needs be committed to this corridor, because as far as we're concerned, this is just another hallway of the Enon Tabernacle Baptist Church.
I think everything was answered, so they probably no. Any questions? If you have any questions, just all of the staff, the Commerce Department staff, can you all just come forward, Nazara, come forward. Didn't see Karen. I know we drove. Brad, is your team here? Medina staff, the people who've done the work. Can you all come forward? Come forward, Celine. Listen, and I just want you, from really for the community and the residents who are here. I want it, Dwayne. Can you come forward? Where is she? This is the boss lady. You need to know. Come up here, Yvonne. When we have been sort of trying to get all of this together, we could have all of the conversations that we wanted. And you all know, I know that I can be pushy sometimes, y'all, right? So listen, I apologize in advance for the next phase's pushing. But I really want to say a heartfelt thank you to you. Yvonne, you came out to every meeting that we had, you and your team. Nazara, you've been with us. We've walked Wadsworth. We've walked this quarter. We just had the meeting at Mass Jijala. Salim, you and your team, all of you. Any language barriers that you're here? Now, I'm getting used. You're a new member of the team. Tell me your name again. GHAG. No longer can anyone attempt to use a language barrier as a challenge, because we don't care if it's Korean, if it's Vietnamese, if it's a Dominican, it doesn't matter what it is, we're going to have a translator available in order to do that, and that's because of the leadership of this team. So, you know, I started from the ground up as a staff person, and when you, you know, when you start that way, you have a great deal of respect for the people who work in the vineyard. And so I just want to say a special thank you to each of you. Thank you all so very much for coming.